This is Lloyd Pettit, and tonight from the Boston Garden in Boston, it's the Chicago Blackhawks versus the Boston Bruins.
Chicago Blackhawk Hockey. Brought to you by Anheuser-Busch Incorporated, brewers of Busch, Budweiser, and Michelob.
Tony and Stan are back in Chicago looking in tonight and hoping, of course, for the same thing that we're hoping for, that the Blackhawks can snap this current losing streak and beat the Boston Bruins here at the Garden, which is quite a sizable assignment here this evening. The Bruins have been undefeated for 15 straight here in the Garden. So it should prove interesting. We hope you'll stay with us. We'll be back with the start of the game in just a moment.
I hate taking my car in for service. How do I know?
Out off the near corner, Coral. To Hull. To Martin, short right wing. A shot and a goal! Beautiful play on the part of Dennis Hull, who dug forward on the backboard and got it out to Pitt Martin on short right wing, and Martin put it by. Cheevers and the Blackhawks have a lead over the Bruins, and here's a look at it in the replay with Coral digging in the corner. The puck sliding along the backboard. A Dennis Hull right wing lead to Martin, and Martin flips it past Cheevers between the pads, and the Hawks lead it 1-0. For a two-period total of 10. So at the end of two, it's Boston 3, Chicago 1. And our second intermission coming your way in just a moment.
Thank you very much, Lloyd Pettit. So the Blackhawks really have their work cut out for them. And after tonight, both the Blackhawks and Vancouver will have five games left. Now, the Blackhawks have weekend games at the stadium with the Rangers in town Saturday and Minnesota on Sunday. Then they take on Kansas City here in Chicago, and they wind up the season with home-and-home games against the St. Louis Blues. Dale Talon is just 4 points away from becoming the highest-scoring defenseman in Blackhawk history, a record currently shared by Dick Redmond and Pierre Palat. Right now, Talon is the third leading scorer on the Blackhawks, and Dale, I'm curious, do you consider this your best year?
Well, I'd have to agree with you. As far as offensively is concerned, this is probably my best season. My first year as a professional in Vancouver, I scored a lot of points as a defenseman. Since then, I've been playing forward, and I've been injured and had a few disorders. But this year, I'm healthy, and I'm playing a position that...
some of the percussion cones.
The xylophones, the chimes.
This is a safety feature that they've added in the last 10 years. It's a plastic plug, so if one should fall on someone, it wouldn't cut them. The blade is a real hard blade, which gives you a real fine edge.
You've got the other skate over there. Why don't you show us what you do with them?
Okay, I'll start up the machine here.
Now, what have you done here, Lou? You've got a hollow edge on here, and does the grinder take care of that?
Right. What I've done here is I've ran over the blade 5 or 6 times, and now the skate is all ready to be used for the game.
And how long will it maintain that sharp edge?
For at least one game or a practice, at least 2 days.
So you have to work on these about every day?
Right, every second day.
Lou, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Lou Varga, one of the trainers for the Blackhawks and the man who takes care of all the skates.
By Marks, Degler with a loose puck over the blue line, giving it to Marks, and Marks coming in on left wing. Gives to Bolderev. Bolderev's shot broken up as he gets it underway. Marks can't hold it. Talon digging for it. Marks comes on, kicks at it, but it's poked out to center ice and Murray. Off the near board to John Marks. Marks leading on the right wing. Over the blue line, broken up by Edestrand. Let out to center ice, and 22 seconds left in the Boston penalty. Talon to Boldarev. To the blue line. Boldarev spreading it out on the far side. Leading to the near point now, and Talon. Talon leading it into the slot, but it was deflected and cleared away by Schmotz and picked up now by Shepard. Penalty is almost over. And Smith is back on the ice. The teams are back at full and equal strength. Talon's pass intercepted by Schmotz in front. A backhander is wide to the left side and off the back of the net. Pulled out of there by Cashman. Popped up into the air to Schmotz in the near corner. Along the backboard to Cashman. Cashman checked by Talon. Cashman trying to get back to it to give it to Schmotz out in front. Led in front. Broken up by Murray. Picked up by Cashman. He loses it in turn. And now Marks throws it out to center ice and Smith. Cashman's drop pass intercepted by Bordalo. Picked up by Shepard. Deflected away by Marks. And Marks to center ice. Trying to kick it ahead and can't do it. Smith picks it up and gives it to Schmotz to the blue line. Left wing lead to Cashman off the far board. Cashman to Schmotz. Then Schmotz to the side of the net, behind the net, into the near corner to Cashman. Cashman looking, leading, giving to Shepard. Check from the side. Marks breaks up the play. Loose puck picked up by Schmotz to Cashman. Cashman with a shot and a save by Villemur, and the loose puck to the side of the net. And Schmotz continues to dig for it. Gives to Schmotz. Can't get his shot away, and Murray clears it off the near board. Popped up into the air, back into the Blackhawks zone and off the near board as Boldarev is put into the boards and the puck behind the net. Cleared by Villemur to the far board and Bordalo. Kept in by Cashman, and Cashman is tripped up by Bordalo, and we have a penalty against Chicago. So the Bruins go to power play hockey. One of the goals that they scored, the first in the second period by Rattel, was a power play goal. And we'll be back with more from Boston right after this.
What goes through your mind when you make a bad call and you know right away you made a bad call?
Well, you sort of want to kick yourself in the seat, but to be perfectly honest with you, if I'd blown the whistle before I should have, and the player going to come up to me, I said, I'd blown the whistle. What do you want me to do about it? I made a bad call. And you just hope that the goal wasn't scored on it or something, and then you're really in trouble.
Yeah.
But the players are understanding.
I think that's a good policy. You know, just look, I admit it, you're trying, I made a bad call, at least.
Providing you're not doing too many of them.
Well, true. But, you know, when you make an obvious bad call and then you deny it, then that's really got to make somebody mad.
And we have also provisions in our rules. If we make a mistake on an icing call, we take it to center ice. Sometimes you might seen an icing call where it was obviously a mistake, and the two officials huddled for a minute. Instead of taking it all the way down into the other zone, we take it right to center ice and start all over again. So both teams are maybe not happy, but they're content that they one team hasn't got the advantage over the other.
You know, I would think another hard part of your job would be... We've been long overdue for interviewing one of the players' wives with Marilyn Esposito out here for a Blackhawk practice along with her younger son, Jason. We thought we'd take the opportunity right now. Jason's been out skating around for a few minutes and 4 years old, and I noticed he doesn't have the tools of your husband's trade. Are you raising him up to be a winger or something?
Well, Tony has Mark, who's on... Mark has been skating for about 5 years and has wanted to go in the net so bad, but Tony said... It's a pressure situation for a young kid to be under, and Tony thinks child should have fun at the game and not be put under pressure at such an early age.
Well, do you think he may eventually be stubborn enough to be a goaltender anyway?
I don't know. Mark seems to go into spots. He plays softball in the summer, and where is he? Catcher. And so I think he'll probably tend to go that way. I hope not, but I have a feeling.
course, by just being a good skater, I mean, that you need that to become a goaltender, right?
Yes, well, that's where a lot of children think that, you know, go stand in the nets and they're going to be super players. Well, that's not the way it goes.
The announcers for this telecast have been selected and approved by the Chicago Blackhawk Hockey Team Incorporated and WFLD-TV. This has been a Kaiser Broadcasting Sports presentation.